Hey everyone, welcome to Crash Course 104, Induced Drag. Induced drag is probably one of the most misunderstood topics in the aviation industry. To any of the student pilots watching my videos, have you ever asked your instructor to explain induced drag in detail? Have you ever noticed that they have a little bit of trouble answering that? You know, they'll say stuff like, oh yeah, it's drag induced by lift, or something to the effect of, oh yeah, you get induced drag when you have a high angle of attack. Then you press them further and you realize they don't really know what they're talking about. And then they go onto the whiteboard, they draw a couple squiggly lines, a couple arrows pointing up that say lift, and magically they just draw a couple of arrows that go backward and they explain this is what induced drag is. Which is followed by the students saying, what? Huh? I don't get what? I don't get it. How does that make any sense? By the end of this video, I'm hoping you have a deeper understanding of what induced drag is, as well as being able to visualize it in your mind. Induced drag is caused by wingtip vortexes that affect the airflow pattern about the wing. I think I'm getting ahead of myself. Let me first mention a couple of concepts. First, we have something called an infinite wing. And then secondly, we have something called a finite wing. An infinite wing is a theoretical wing that does not have a wingtip because it's so long, and therefore it does not have a wingtip vortex. High aspect ratio wings are the closest thing that we have towards infinite wings. A finite wing actually has a wingtip, therefore suffers from wingtip vortexes. The wing I have drawn in front of me is a cross-section of an infinite wing. There is perfect airflow over the top and the bottom, and no distortions from any wingtip vortexes. The wing has a very uniform airflow, therefore the lift pattern about the wing is going to be the same, and it pulls vertically, ideally perfect lift. In reality, a wing does have wingtip vortexes, and the vortexes affect the airflow pattern about the tip of the wing. Can you see it? Can you visualize it now? Induced drag is not some sort of friction that the airplane is feeling as it's flying through the air. The lift vector itself is the drag. It is actually being pulled backwards. The vortex, as it's circling from bottom to top in a helical formation, causes a local airflow disturbance. And what it ends up doing is causes a lesser angle of attack. You heard me correctly, less angle of attack. Hear me out. All pilots will agree that lift is perpendicular to the relative wind. Let's say that you're in a glider or a small airplane flying over the desert. You hit a very large thermal heat wave from the ground. You get an increase in your average angle of attack. The lift will increase, and the pilot, in order to maintain his current altitude, will have to push forward on the stick. If the pilot does that, the aircraft will begin to speed up. That explains the horizontal X component that's aiming forward. You can see in this exaggerated illustration, a negative angle of attack actually causes the green lift vector to tilt backwards. Lift is perpendicular to the average relative wind. The average between the incoming relative wind and the outgoing relative wind is what calculates your induced angle of attack. The induced angle of attack is that I-shaped figure I have in between those two lines in colored magenta. If you minimize that, you minimize your induced drag. And the way to minimize your induced angle of attack is to minimize wake vortexes. An increase in lift causes wing vortices. Wing vortices cause airflow distortion. And that airflow distortion is what causes the lift vector to tilt backwards. And that is your induced drag. I really hope you liked and got something from this video. The aviation community is small as it is. If you liked this video, give it a thumbs up. If you really liked it, subscribe. And if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to write them in the section below. I respond to comments as quickly as I can, and I'm sorry it took so long to get this video up and running. I've been a little bit busy. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.